Welcome back to my channel. Today in Algebra 1, we're going to learn how to solve radical equations. Radical equations? Radical is nothing but a square root. So it's basically a square root equation. But how would you solve for x? We have the square root of x equals 10. If we had a normal equation like x minus 4 equals 3, you would add 4 so we can remove that. Or if it was multiplication, we would divide to do the opposite. But what would you do here? So to solve a radical equation where you have the square root of x equals 10, the opposite of taking the square root of a number is squaring that number. So we're gonna square both sides. So squaring the square root of x, it will cancel out the square root, giving us x equals 10 squared, which is 10 times 10, so x equals 100. And if you want to plug that in, 100, so the square root of 100 is indeed 10. So it is true. All right, let me give you guys some other examples. Let's say we have square root of v minus 4 equals 3. To start, I'm going to square both sides of the equation, canceling out the square root, giving us v minus 4 equals 3 times 3 is 9. Now let's solve the equation, and we get v equals 13. Let's check this. 13 minus 4 is 9, and the square root of 9 is 3. This is a correct statement. All right, let me give you some more examples. You have 2 equals the square root of 4b. To start, I'm going to square both sides of the equation, giving us 4 equals 4b. Now I'm going to divide both sides by 4, giving us b equals 1. And that is our solution for number 3. All right, I'm gonna give you guys some examples to try. Try this tricky one. Negative 8 plus the square root of 5a minus 5 equals negative 3. I'm going to give you guys some time to solve the equation for a. All right, so let me solve this. So start, we're not going to start by squaring the equation to get rid of it. First, we have terms. So first, I'm going to add 8 to both sides, giving us the square root of 5a minus 5 equals negative 3 plus 5 is 5. Now we can square both sides of the equation, giving us 5a minus 5 equals 25. Now I'm going to add 5 to both sides of the equation, giving us 5a equals 30. And now, last step, divide both sides by 5, giving us a equals 6. And this is our solution in number 4. All right, I'm going to give some more examples for you guys. Let's say we have 10 times the square root of 9x equals 60. All right, solve this. Since the 10 is being multiplied to the square root, instead of squaring first, we're going to divide both sides by 10, giving us the square root of 9x is equal to 6. Now I'm going to square both sides of the equation, giving us 9x equals 36. Now I'm going to divide both sides by 9, giving us x equals 4. Now, this is our solution. If you want to go back and check it, 9 times 4 is 36. The square root of 36 is 6, and 10 times 6 is 60. So that is a correct and only our correct solution. All right. Let's say we have, for our last problem on this video, I'm going to go over, see how the square root of x plus 8 equals the square root of 3x plus 8. What would you do here? So we're going to start as normal by squaring both sides, but the square root only cancels. So we're only going to have x plus 8 equals 3x plus 8. It's only canceling at the square root. Now let's solve this equation for x. Subtracting x from both sides give us 8 equals 2x plus 8. Now I'm going to subtract both sides by 8, giving us 2x equals 0. Now I'm going to divide both sides by 2, giving us x equals 0. That is our solution. 0 is our solution for this last problem. Thank you so much for watching. For radical equations on how to solve. Thank you and bye.